I spent some time the other day experimenting with colorizing a black and white photograph, so I thought I'd use that topic for today's tutorial. The image I worked on is a photo of my granddad from World War II. The original has that washed out sepia look to it, as you would expect from a snapshot from the 1940s, but after scanning and processing it in Photoshop, it's brought to life in full color and much better contrast, which really helps you imagine the scene for real. So find yourself an old black and white photograph to practice this colorization technique with yourself. No doubt an old photo scan will have some damage or dust speckles. Right click on the layer to make it a smart object, then use the filter, noise, dust and scratches filter to remove any speckles from the scan. A value of 1 to 2 pixels and a threshold of around 30 to 40 works pretty well to get rid of the specks without interfering with the photo contents. Add a black and white adjustment layer to neutralize the photograph, then add a levels adjustment layer to fix the contrast. You'll probably need to darken the shadows quite a lot. Converting the document to cmyk is an important next step. Go to Image Mode in cmyk, then merge the layers when asked. If you compare the addition of color to an RGB document in a cmyk document, you'll notice that the tones of the image show through much more in RGB than they do in cmyk, where instead they tend to colorize the darker areas much better. To begin adding color to your image, add a solid color adjustment layer. Select a hue that roughly represents the area of the image you're working on. Change the blending mode to soft light to allow the color to interact with the existing tones of the black and white photograph. Alternatively, you could try the color blending mode, which retains much more vibrancy within your hue selections. Select the layer mask that is added alongside the adjustment layer. Fill it with black to clear the color overlay from the entire image. Switch to the brush tool and adjust the tip to around 10% hardness and a size to suit the area you're working on. Make sure the foreground color selection is set to white, which will restore the color from the mask, then begin painting over the areas which require this particular color. Switch the brush color back over to black within the toolbar or hit the X key as a shortcut. Painting with black will erase the color again, so use it to remove the color from unwanted areas or to clean up any mistakes. Double click the solid color layer to edit the color selection. It's easier to match the hue when you can see the live preview. You can always adjust the opacity of the layer to tone down the impact of the color you've chosen. Paint over the image everywhere else where this color selection is required. I found that overlaying some extra colors over the face helped boost the realism a little. Pink around the eyes and on the cheeks, yellow on the forehead, and blue around the shaved beard area, all made almost invisible with sub 20% opacities, just helped add some subtle variation in color. When using the brush tool to paint over the photo like this, a pen tablet makes the job much easier. It's still possible to use this technique with a mouse, but if you're having some trouble, you might instead want to try making selections with the pen tool. To do this, trace around the outline of each portion of the photo that needs colorizing, then right click and choose Make Selection. Add a 1 pixel feathering to avoid any hard edges, then fill the selection with white to instantly apply the color to this area. Once you've finished colorizing your photo with a range of solid color adjustment layers, there's a couple of final tweaks that I found made a huge difference. The first was a hue and saturation adjustment layer right at the top of the layer stack. Bumping up the saturation helps improve the vibrancy and compensates for any color selections that were too dull. A color balance adjustment layer also helps you correct the overall tone of the photo, where you can warm up or cool down the shadows, midtones and highlights by balancing between yellows and blues. The final image is a complete transformation compared to the original photo scan. The addition of color really brings the shot to life and makes the scene much more relatable. So I hope these tips give you some inspiration to colorize some old black and white photos you might own. If you enjoyed the video or learned anything new, a thumbs up would be really appreciated. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.